What's going on, guys? It's another sourcing day. It's the first auction of the year for me, so I'm really excited. I haven't been to one in like 3 weeks, so I'm really excited to get back out there and see what we can get. Start off the year with a bang, but I'm gonna bring you guys along for the journey. We'll see what kind of treasures we find today. If it's your first time watching one of my videos, I buy things to flip on eBay, Amazon, Mercari, mainly eBay, but that's what we're doing today. We're gonna go find some cool stuff at the auction to flip online. So I stopped at the Goodwill like I often do on the way to the auction, absolutely scored. Spent 200 bucks on this stuff. Six of it was for some socks for myself. So I spent about 195 on stuff to resell. I paid 35 for this, should sell for 125. Got that for 35, it's worth about 140 bucks with all those accessories. The Technics was $13. If it's for parts, it's worth 50. If it works, it's worth about 120. Sony receiver was 30 and it's worth 125. These are brand new with tags. I paid 30. I'll probably get about 65 for them. Those Tiva sandals look like they're brand new. I paid 15, should get 35 to 40. This printer is like in perfect condition. I only paid $8 for it and it's worth over 100. And then I got the Georgia Bulldogs Nikes back there for 15 and they're worth about 40 in that condition. But Gray Hall from Goodwill.
Lot 43. You got choice on two Star Wars Mandalorian babies.
Wow! Child. 25, pretty good, 25, $10, let's go.
So we're back at the warehouse. I got everything pulled out. I got stuff on this table and this table from the auction. I spent $475 total, so I'll go ahead and run through this stuff real quick. I spent $60 on the Apple computer. That's nice. And these you can actually sell separate from this because it's a little bit older model. I gotta look up the exact specifications and model and everything, but with a quick search, I think this could sell for around $200 and this should sell for around $150. I paid 60 bucks for the complete set, so that'll be 60 into $350, maybe even more. We'll have to see. I bought these boxes for $40 each. I think I should get around $100 per flat, so $80 into roughly $200. This is a really nice set of china. A lot of people won't bid on china because it's so bulky, it's hard to ship. If there are other kinds of resellers where they sell on marketplace or at like flea markets and stuff, they're not gonna buy items like this. So when you're at the auction, you can really get a good deal on stuff like this. I only paid $50 for this whole set. It's probably 50 pieces, but here's what it is. Royal Dalton Carlisle. Check out these sold comps. And I also got this French poster. I saw one that sold for $150. There's a couple listed and people are asking astronomical prices, like $500, $700. So I think I should get around $150 for it, and I paid 40 bucks. Here's another really nice china set. This one over here, I should get about $500 for that, and I only paid 50. This one here, I paid $30 for, and it's actually, I should get around $300 for it. Lennox Monroe. There's about 50 pieces in here. A bunch of cups in here for the set. All kinds of like dinner plates and salad plates and other stuff over here. And then of course all these plates. Really nice set. Both these sets are about 50 pieces. I'll show you a sold comp on this set as well. We have these last few items over here on this table. This is a nice Canon EOS Rebel camera with a nice lens, an additional lens. I paid 50 bucks for this. I gotta do a little bit more research, but I think I should get $100 or more out of it. I paid $15 for this and they threw in the Yamaha speakers. I'm not gonna sell them together. I'm gonna sell this Onkyo, I don't even know if I said that right, tuner amplifier by itself. I think it's worth about 120 bucks. And these I'll have to do a little bit of research on. If they're not worth much, I might throw them up on Marketplace and try to get like 15 or 20 bucks. And if they don't sell in a couple weeks, I'll just donate them. I paid 40 bucks for these four knives. They're all Boy Scout knives. and they're made by good makers and they're actually in good condition. They should bring about $30 each. I might lot them up in the two different lots like this, but I'm not sure yet. This was more of a gamble than anything. I didn't see this stuff before the auction, and then when the auctioneer put it up, I was kind of intrigued by it. And he mentioned that somebody had paid $575 for it originally, and everything in the box looks like it's untouched. So if somebody paid $575 for it, and it's like an interesting thing, a dry sell kit for engines, which I don't even know exactly what it does, but I only paid $20 for it. Hopefully I can get some more, and hopefully I'll make a bunch of money off it. I don't know, I'll let you guys know if I sell it and end up getting a few hundred dollars. That'd be epic. And then I paid $50 for this photo album, which is probably a little much, but like I'm kind of like infatuated by old World War II stuff, and I know it's worth more than 50. There's probably a couple dozen, there's a few dozen pictures in here. There's some cool like 8x10s, stuff you don't see very often. But yeah, there's an 8x10, General Patton there. This was like a commemorative thing though, not an actual photo, but these are actual photos. And collectors really like these, so I just really wanted this for myself more than anything, but I'll probably still resell it and get like $75, maybe $100 out of it after I enjoy it. And then last but not least, the best thing I got at the auction was this knife right here, and I only paid $25 for it. I thought I was gonna get in a bidding war and have to pay a bunch of money, but it's called a jackknife, made by Ben in Chicago. I've never heard of it, and I've sold a bunch of knives. It's got the nice scales and everything, but check out these sold comps. I just found this out in the vehicle. I forgot this was one more item I picked up at the auction. I only paid $5 for this, and if you look this up, the Verifone VX520. These are selling for around $100, and it's complete with the power cable, manual, Discord. Looks like it's ready to go. So all in all, it was a pretty good sourcing day. We got some good stuff at the Goodwill on the way there, and we got some really good stuff at the auction. The total I spent was $670. I spent roughly $195 at Goodwill and $475 at the auction. For the stuff I got at Goodwill, I think I can resell for around $750. I'm talking about gross here. Obviously, there's going to be some fees that come out of the back end. And then for the stuff I got at the auction, I think I can get around $2,200. And I only spent $475 on that stuff. So I should be able to sell it for like 4 or 5 times more than what I paid for it. And that's when you know it's a good auction. You know, when you could triple, quadruple, quintuple your investment, that's great. And that's the best thing about sourcing secondhand goods from yard sales, estate sales, thrift stores, and live auctions. You get these ridiculous margins that I couldn't get and if I was buying pallets and truckloads and things of that nature. And I've been doing this long enough where I've bought entire truckloads and I've made a lot of money, but it's taken me several months. You know, it's like I invested like $12,000 in this large truckload, and it took me like 3 or 4 months just to get all the stuff listed. I mean, it just seemed like this huge ordeal. So to me, this is the best way to source these secondhand goods. You can get high profit margins and low overhead, low investment, and it's a lot of fun. It's like going out there and treasure hunting. My next video, or one of my next videos, I'll do another what sold video, and I'll pick items that were in the recent videos, kind of like this, these haul videos. So that way you'll see what I'm actually selling this stuff for, and I'll show you that I do know what I'm talking about. But yeah, that's about it for today. If you guys have any like questions or comments, drop them below and I'll be happy to get back to you. If you have any ideas for like the next kind of video I should make or some topic you think I should discuss, let me know that as well and I'll probably make the video for you guys. But I appreciate you watching. If you made it this far, thank you so much. And if you haven't subscribed already, please do that. And until next time, peace.